Sesame Street shows 71 in color.
Mr. Looper, Hooper, you're doing some work, aren't you? I can tell. And I'm going to help you because remember last week how much I helped you? Can I help you?
I'll have to think about it.
Huh? Oh, well, what is it you're going to do?
I'm going to paint the sign to put on the front window to sell orange juice.
I'm a great sign painter, Mr. Looper.
Hooper?
Mr. Hooper, I'm a great sign painter, and I can paint your sign for you.
To paint the sign, you have to know the letters of the alphabet.
Oh, well, I know the letters of the alphabet. Want to hear me say them?
Go ahead.
Okay. what's the first letter?
A.
Oh, well, see, once I got the A, I got all the rest. A, B, C, Q, L... No, those come later.
Big Bird, why don't you listen to Lou Rawls say the alphabet?
Here's a song I'm gonna sing. A song that you can sing. Story of the ABCs. After a while, I want you to join me. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z, A, B, C. That's your A, B, C. Now you come on and join with me. I said A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N-O-P, Q-R-S, T-U-V, W-X-Y, for the great big Z, A-B-C's, A-B-C, that's your A, and your B. ABCs.
Oh, boy, I'm going to be a sign painter and paint a sign for Mr. Hooper. But wait a minute. How do you begin the word orange in the word orange juice? Oh, boy.
Hello, Big Bird.
Oh, Gordon, I'm glad you're here. I'm stuck.
What's the matter?
I'm painting a sign for Mr. Hooper, and I don't know how to do it, you see.
Well, what's the sign supposed to say?
Orange juice.
Orange juice.
But I don't know how to begin the word orange.
Oh, well, look, the first letter in the word orange, can you try to think of it? Orange. It's a letter that sounds like
R?
Oh, no, not an arm, no.
L?
No, okay, now, do you know how to make an O?
No.
Well, I'll tell you, what shape is an orange? It's the same shape as the letter O.
It is?
Sure, what shape is an orange? You've seen an orange,
it's round,
that's
like
right.
A circle.
Yeah, come here, let me show you.
Okay,
watch this.
Let me see.
It goes sort of like this way. It's an O.
Oh.
O. Open. Oh. Open. 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 Oh.
Grow and go. Roll over the road where the goat explodes all the O's and the crow flies low. Past the croaking toad and the boat floats over the ocean, but the wind did blow and it started to snow. So the toad went home to the telephone. He spoke to the goat who was eating a bowl of bone, potatoes and soap. A rope did float and hooked the goat, and the boy climbed the stone made of oak. The O's turned to smoke and started to float closer to the bulldozer, who closed up the hole so the cold wind could not blow, and the sun did show so the roses could grow, and the whole world would know that the boat bulldozer, the toad and the crow, the boy and the rope, riding the goat, were all okay.
Okay?
Oh. Open. Oh.
Open. Open.
Oh.
Hey, Bert. Bert, come in here. Come on in here, Bert.
Yeah.
Hey, Bert.
Yeah,
I got a quiz for you.
What do you want now?
I got a quiz for you, Bert.
Oh, boy, not another game.
Yes, yes. This is a quiz, and it's called What Happened Here? See? Now, what's going to happen is I'm going to show you a picture, and you have to tell me what happened just before I drew it, right?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, ready?
Except these games are always so simple, you know, Ernie.
Not this one.
All right.
Take a look at this.
Yeah.
Now, here's a picture of a bird cage.
Yeah.
And the door on the bird cage is open.
Yeah.
Now, what has just happened?
Well, what happened is the door opened, and the bird flew out.
Why, that's right. Hmm. Well,
was that one of your hard ones?
Well, we'll get another one.
I hope so.
Okay. Here's a picture of a man. That's a man. And down here is a banana peel.
Yeah?
Now, what has just happened?
Well, the man just stepped on the banana peel and fell down.
Yeah, so, well, that's right, too. I bet you peeked at these, Bert.
No, I didn't. They're all so simple, Ernie. I told you that
before. Here's a tough one. Here's a tough one, Bert. Let's see if you can tell me what happened here.
What happened there?
Mm-hmm.
Ernie, I don't see anything.
Oh, well, you give up?
No, give up. That's ridiculous. The paper's absolutely blank.
This is a picture of a cow eating grass.
I don't see any grass.
Of course not. The cow ate it.
I don't see any cow.
Well, after she ate the grass, she went
home.
She went home.
Why should she stay around? Sure.
Six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
No, that's not a letter. What does that begin with? That's not it. No,
hi,
I can't.
Big Bird. Oh, I see you got the orange part of the sign up. Gordon told me he helped you.
Yes, Susan, he did help me. I got the word orange done, but now I can't spell the word juice.
Oh, well, juice starts with the letter J. Now, do you know how to make a J?
No.
Well, let's see. Jump starts with the letter J. Jelly bean. Jelly.
Wait a minute. I know one. The word jam begins with the letter J.
Here, give me your brush and I'll show you how to make the letter J.
Okay.
Okay, now say it with me.
All right.
J.
J.
Let's go over it again.
J.
And put the dot right up
dot.
Here. Yeah.
J. Jam. Strawberry jam. My favorite kind. J.
What's happening, man?
I don't know.
What's that?
I don't know. Looks like a fish hook.
It's not a fish hook. It's a J.
A what?
The letter J. Like to hear a story about the letter J, boys?
Yeah.
Once upon a time, a guy named Joe noticed a June bug on his toe. Put it in a jar and started to go. But here come the judge and said, no, no, no. So Joe said why and started to jump and dance a jig on an old tree stump. Then jogged along to the city dump where he jammed the June bug in a tire pump. Then the judge caught up and started to wail and said to Joe, justice will prevail. Then the jury met and set the bail and Joe got an hour in the city jail.
So that's the letter J. It still looks like a fish hook. You know what else we learned?
Yeah, don't drive a jet by jamming a June bug.
Hello to you today. I want to show you something. See this letter? It's the letter J. Know what this is? It's a jack-in-the-box. Jack-in-the-box begins with the letter J. Want to see how it works?
Wow! That's a good job.
Really?
As a matter of fact, that's an A1 job.
Really?
That shows you really know the letters in the alphabet.
Well...
That's terrific.
I did have a little help from Gordon and Susan.
Yes, but you learned. And when you learn something, you can do almost anything.
Gosh.
You know what we have here, Chris?
What?
Well, let's see if we can guess what it is. It's an animal that starts with the letter A. We had one before here, only we had a much bigger one.
Ape.
Not an ape, no. And he's got a very, very long nose.
Oh, antelope?
Oh, no, not an antelope. And you know how he gets most of his food?
How?
By sticking his tongue out. He has a very, very long tongue. And he can stick his tongue right out. I'll give you a really good clue. You know what he likes to eat best of all?
What?
Ants. Can you think what he might be? He eats ants. It's an ant eater. It's an ant eater. Now look, see how his claws sort of cling right around that chair there?
Yeah.
They're very, very strong, powerful claws. And when he goes out to hunt his food, he comes upon a big anthill and he knocks the anthill down with those very sharp claws, very powerful claws. And then he has a long tongue and he sticks the tongue out and it's sort of sticky. And all of the ants will stick right to his tongue. And he also likes termites. Doesn't that sound delicious?
Termites.
Wouldn't you like that for breakfast tomorrow morning?
Termites?
Termites, yeah, those are little bugs that eat wood. Now, do you know where this animal comes from?
Yeah. Where?
Well, mostly in South America in the jungles. He's a good climber, too. He can climb not only with his feet, but he has a special tail. It's something like a monkey's tail. It's called a prehensile tail. He can use that like a foot also. They like to play up in the trees and jump around and climb up in trees also. That's how they like to play.
Can they swing?
Swing, yeah. They can swing with their tail a little bit. Hey, Chris, would you like to see some other animals and see how they play?
Yeah.
Here are some apes. Watch them play now.
play. Here are some things that belong together. Are you ready? Okay. Here are some things that belong together. Here are some things that are kind of the same. Here are some things that belong together. Now it's time to play our game. All right, let's look over here at these two things. One of these things belongs with the other. See if you can guess which one. Guess which thing belongs with the other. Do it before my song is done. All right, let's look back over here and decide, why do these three things belong together? This is a light bulb, a candle, and this is the sun. Now, this is a flashlight and the telephone. Now, which one of these two things really belongs on this side of the board? Do you think you know? Let's see if you're right. Which of these things goes with the other? Do you think that this one might? If you guess that this thing goes with the other, then you're absolutely right. Okay, let's put the flashlight right over here and let's see if that makes a nice picture. Okay, now why does the flashlight belong here? All right, let's think, what does each thing do? The light bulb gives off light in the lamp. The candle gives off light. The sun gives off nice warm light. And the flashlight gives off light. And of course, the telephone, we use that to talk with, right? So that's why these things all go together. Did you get that? We got another one. All right, let's see how you do on this one. Here are some things that belong together. Here are some things that are kind of the same. Here are some things that belong together. Now it's time to play our game. All right, let's look on the other side of the board. One of these things goes with the other. Do you? Oh, see if you can guess which one. Guess which thing goes with the other. But do it before my song is done. All right, let's look at these things over here. This is a mitten, a pair of boots, and a scarf. Now, why do these three things go together? This is a pair of earmuffs and a toy car. Now, one of these belongs over here. Do you know which one? Which of these things goes with the other? Do you think that this one might? If you guess that this thing goes with the others, then you're absolutely right. Put it right over there, the earmuffs. And you have all your cold weather gear. You have your mittens, your boots, the scarf, and your earmuffs, so you can go out and play in the snow. And you would wear all these, but you'd just take your car with you. You wouldn't wear it, right? That was pretty good.
Oh, cookie, cookie!
No, no, and that is it. You are not going to eat any of these cookies, because these cookies are all mine, all except one of them, and that belongs to my old buddy Bert. And so keep your fingers off those cookies, because you can't have any of them, so you might as well just leave. He always wants my cookies, but just look at them. Aren't they beautiful? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cookies. You know, sometimes I think that looking at cookies is the nicest thing of all, but then I remember that looking at cookies is not the nicest thing of all, because the nicest thing of all is eating cookies, and that's what I'm going to do right now. I wonder who that can be. Come in. Well, hello there.
Hi.
Who are you?
A baker.
You're a baker?
Yeah.
Oh, well, it's sort of nice to meet you. What kind of things do you bake?
Huh?
I say, what kind of things do you bake?
Cookies.
Cookies?
Cookies.
Isn't that interesting?
Oh?
You know, I happen to have some cookies right here.
Oh, yes. Cookies.
Yes.
Taste?
Oh, well, certainly, if you'd like to taste one.
Yeah.
I'd like to have a professional opinion. Go right ahead. What do you think? Try another one.
Yeah, another. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay. Good.
Oh, yeah. Good. I'm glad you liked it.
Very good.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Oh, you're more than welcome.
Bye-bye.
Yes, goodbye. See ya. Baker come to visit. Wasn't that interesting? Well, I hope he enjoyed the cookies. Well, now I don't have all the cookies anymore, because, of course, the baker got a couple of them. But it's still a few of them here, and it's time for cookie eating! And that's what I'm going to do. I wonder who that can be. Come in.
Hello.
Well, hi there. Who are you?
Little girl.
A little girl. Well, it's nice to meet you, little girl. What can I do for you?
Hungry.
You're hungry.
This
poor little girl is hungry.
Oh.
Yes. Well, listen, I happen to have a few cookies here. Would you like a cookie?
Oh, yeah, cookie.
Mm-hmm. Well, go ahead. Help yourself.
Oh, thank you.
Mm-hmm. You know, you sort of remind me of somebody.
Oh.
Yeah. You don't happen to know that baker who was just in here, do you?
Baker?
Yeah.
Daddy!
Oh, yeah. He was your daddy?
Yeah, my daddy.
Well, yeah. That explains that.
Oh, yeah.
Sure. Hey, listen, if you're hungry, you're welcome to, you know, help yourself to cookies then.
Two cookies?
Sure, go ahead.
Two?
Have another.
Oh, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Delicious.
Oh, good. I'm
thank
glad.
You.
Glad you liked it.
Nice
sure.
Man.
Okay. All right. Well, gee, I did have all the cookies, and then I had some of the cookies, and now I only have one cookie, and I think that's Bert's cookie.
Hey, Ernie. Oh, boy, hey. Ernie. Huh. Oh, you should have seen that. You won't believe this. Guess who I saw. You know that monster who always tries to get your cookies?
The monster?
Yeah, well, I saw him outside dressed like a little girl. Boy, did he look funny.
The monster? Oh. Dressed like a little girl?
Oh, that's my cookie. Thank you. Yeah, boy, he was wearing a little dress and pigtails. Boy, did he look funny. Well, now that I have my cookie, I think I'll go. Thanks for taking care of it, okay?
Yeah.
See you, Aaron.
Yeah, Bert, sure. Gee, well, I did have all the cookies, and then I had some of the cookies, and then I had just one cookie. But that was Bert's cookie, so now I got no cookies. Oh well.
Some of us are here, but not all of us. Now none of us are there. Now some of us are here, but not all of us. Now none of us are there. But now
All of us are here.
Chris and Lance, I'm going to explain to you how a scale works. Now, this is a scale, and in this side, you have a weight. I'll show you what I mean, in case you can't see it. That's a weight. This little piece of metal here weighs something, just like you weigh some pounds, right? And you weigh so much. Do you know how much you weigh? You don't? How about you, Chris? 60 pounds. Okay. Yeah. Well, this isn't 60 pounds, but it does weigh something. So that's some weight. And you notice what happens. As soon as I put this in here, that side gets heavier, right? And this goes down. This goes down, this side. This comes up because there's nothing in here. And we just saw something about none, some, and all. So I'll show you how this is going to work. You see that there is no weight in here at all. Nothing in there, okay? That's empty. Now, I've got a couple of weights in my hand. I have two more weights. Now, if I put some weight in here, see what happens? It moves down just a little bit. But you see, the weight that I put in here is not as heavy as the weight that's on the other side. So that means that this won't come down as far as this will because that's heavier. See? So now you have some weight in here. Now all I have left is one more weight. Okay? Now if I put this in here, that means that all the weight that I had left is in here. So now this has all the weight. And that makes it go down even further. And let me take it one step further to make sure we understand. If I take this out of here and put it here, then all the weight, absolutely all the weight that was up here is over on this one side. So that's all the way down to the bottom now. The other's all the way up at the top. You understand it?
Yes.
You got any questions?
Yes.
You do have some questions? You want to ask me a question about it? Go ahead.
Why does that go down and that has to go up?
Because this is heavier. If you sat in it, if this was a little bigger and you sat in it, don't you think you'd go all the way down and the other side would come up? That's what weight does. It brings things down. Understand now?
I have a question.
Yes.
Like me and my brother are sitting here.
Yeah.
And this is a bigger weight. Uh-huh. Then he would be lifting me up. Now I'm going up in the air because he's heavier than me.
Well, if your brother's heavier than you and he was on one side, that side would go down. The side that you were on would go up. You understand? Because he's heavier. Same thing. You know, it's pretty easy to make the ends of this scale go up and down like a seesaw. It's easy, that is, unless you're somebody like Buddy and Jim.
Hey, Jim! Hey, Jim!
What is it?
What is this thing here?
This is a seesaw.
Oh, yeah. This here's a seesaw.
Seesaw.
Jim, what does a seesaw do?
A seesaw goes up and down.
Kidding, seesaw? Too bad.
What's too bad?
Well, this seesaw is broke.
This seesaw is not broken.
It's not going up and down, Jim.
Everybody knows that you have to sit on a seesaw first before it can go up and down.
Oh, I see. Good.
Yeah, I'll show you.
All right.
Very simple.
I'd like to see you do some seesawing here, Jim.
Well, I'll show you right now.
Come on, Jim.
Sit down on the seesaw.
Seesaw. Seesaw. Hey, Jim. I knew it. This seesaw's broke.
Hold it.
What?
I think you need two people before the seesaw can go up and down.
You gotta have two people
two
before
people
the seesaw
on the
goes
seesaw
up and down?
Before it can work.
Jim, Buddy, one, two, two people.
That's
Let's
fine.
Go, Jim.
Here we go.
Whoopee, seesaw. Let's go, Jim.
Buddy, I think you're right. I think this seesaw is broken.
I sure wanted the seesaw, Jim.
Me too.
Hey, Jim. Got an idea. Maybe
just one end of the seesaw won't work. Maybe we're sitting on the bad end. Let's go over there and try the other end, and maybe we can seesaw.
Buddy, for once in your life, you've had a good idea.
Good boy!
All we have to do is go on the other end,
yeah,
and then the seesaw.
Seesaw. Okay, here we go.
Here we go. It's a good idea.
Thank you, Jim.
Now I sit down.
Yep.
Buddy sits down.
Uh-huh.
Now hold on real tight, because sometimes the seesaw goes high.
Real high, huh?
Are you ready?
Yeah.
On your mark.
Let's go.
Get set. Here we go. Hold it. There's something very wrong here. I've got an idea.
Yeah?
I think you have to use both ends of the seesaw before it can work.
Both ends?
Both ends. I'll tell you what.
Yeah?
I'll stay on this end of the seesaw.
Yeah?
You go way over to the other end of the seesaw, and you sit on that end, and then I think the seesaw's gonna work.
Good boy!
Good boy.
Here we go. Jimmy, stay on that end, will you? What I'll do is I'll go over here on this end, and we'll get this seesaw to... Seesaw. Jim. My end of the seesaw is too high. You can't get on my end of the seesaw, Jim.
You can't do anything right.
Jim, it's too high. You can't get on it.
I have to do it all by myself. Does that look too high to you?
That's not too high, Jim.
Now, sit down here and remember what I told you. You're going to sit on this end, I'm going to sit on this end, and then I think the seesaw's going to work.
You're right, Jim. You always have the good ideas, Jim.
Always have the good ideas. What are you doing on my side of the seesaw?
Oh, I want to seesaw with you, Jim, before it broke again.
You know, there are a lot of families living right here on Sesame Street, but there is one family that you just won't find here. That's the Lion family. You know, but strangely enough, in many ways, they're just like all other families everywhere. Watch.
Thank you.
one thing members of a family have to do is share. Now, Ernie and Bert can tell you just what sharing means.
Okay, let's see. Now, that's one for you.
Yeah.
And one for me. And one more for you. And one for me. There, now we've divided all the jelly beans up. All divided evenly. Share and share alike, Bert, old buddy.
Right.
Yeah, now just for safety, let's just count them to make sure.
Okay.
Now, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 jelly beans. And you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 jelly beans. Wait a minute. Well, there's something wrong here.
Yeah.
Because I have 7 jelly beans, and you have only 6. So I think what we should do is I'll take one of my jelly beans and give it to you.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Now, let's see that. Now, you have, at this point, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 jelly beans. And I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wait a minute.
Here, Ern. And you see, there's some mistake now.
It's true.
Now, I got 7 here.
Yes.
And you've got 6 over there.
Right.
Let's see. Oh, I know. Yeah. Now, you take one of these, one of mine.
All right.
And put it over there.
Take this jelly bean.
Good. Now, you'll have 7 beans just like me.
Oh, thank you, Bert. Now,
sure.
That should even everything up.
Of course.
Let's see. Now, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 jelly beans.
Told you.
And you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Wow.
Wait a minute. Hold it. I think I've got it. Let's see. Now, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 jelly beans.
Yeah.
And I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this jelly bean right here, which is the problem, we just get rid of. There you go, Bert. Everything's evened up. Even Steven, buddy.
Have you seen Oscar, honey?
I haven't seen Oscar all day.
I wonder if he's there.
I bet he is. All we have to do is knock on the can 1 or 2 times. Find out.
Hey, what are you doing, playing music on my trash can?
Yes.
Hi, Oscar.
Yes.
Where
have you been all day, Oscar?
Well, for your information.
Yes.
I have been to a bargain sale.
Oh, a sale?
Kidding. Yeah, It was the Grouch's yearly bargain basement discount sale.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
There were so many terrible things to buy, I just couldn't tear myself away.
Well, what did you buy?
Oh, yeah. Want to see some of the stuff?
Yeah,
sure. Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah, he's going to get his own limb.
Hold that, Gordon.
I will.
That is a bowl for my soup.
Oh, come on, Oscar. That's not a bowl for your soup. That's got holes in it. You'd pour soup in there, it would go right through it all over the floor. You can't drink soup out of a bowl like that.
Well, it just so happens that I don't like soup. So this bowl is just right. Put soup in that. By the time it's cool, there's nothing left.
Come on, Oscar.
Yeah, Oscar. What else did you buy?
Oh, I got something great. A telephone.
Oh, a telephone.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. You want to see that?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, yeah, look at this.
I didn't think you could buy telephones.
No.
Oh, sure. Just plug them in. Yeah, look at that. Isn't that a beauty?
Oscar.
Slightly used.
Yeah, slightly. How about that? Oscar.
Say so?
You can't use this telephone because it doesn't have a receiver. You know the part that you listen in, talk in? You know, that's the part it doesn't... People can't call you on this phone. You can't hear them. You can't talk to anybody. Do you dig? That's not a good phone.
I don't want to talk to people, and I don't want them to talk to me. This phone is perfect. But wait till you see the best thing that I got.
Please.
A television set.
You bought a television from the place?
Yeah, television. Oh. You want to see it?
Yeah, I want
to
see it.
Sure, we like it.
A bargain television.
Yeah, I hope it doesn't emit x-rays. Yeah.
There it goes.
Oscar, that's no television. That's a radio. You watch television, but you don't watch the radio.
It so happens that I like to watch the radio.
Oh, I see.
Find it very restful on my eyes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah?
Gordon?
Yes.
Do me a favor.
What?
Would you just turn that antenna around a little bit? Getting a ghost there.
Turn
a little bit to the left.
Ghost. This way?
Yeah, a little image. The image was a little blurred. Oh, yeah, that's good.
Oh,
yeah.
All right.
Better reception, Oscar?
Oh, yeah. Let me watch it.
You know, a radio is good for lots of other things, though. One is teaching us the letter R.
Can you name this letter? If you said R, you were correct. Let's say R together now. Ready? R! Fine. Now, here's something that starts with the letter R. Do you know what this is? Here, let me help you to guess. Yes, it's a radio. That's a nice tune. My ship has sails that are...
Today, I'm going to tell you about the letter R. R is for rooster. And rubber. And rake. It's also for river. And make no mistake, it's even for rowboat. And rocks. And for rain. That causes the robber to go down the drain. Very well. What letter have we learned about today?
R.
Good heavens. A talking dog.
R. Rabbit. R.
Hi there. Hey, how'd you like to go for a ride with me?
I'm sorry I can't because I'm going for a ride with Billy in his plane. We're going way up in the sky.
A plane? A plane is nothing. I got something better than a plane.
What could be better than a plane?
Well, climb in this and I'll show you.
All right.
Yeah, there's a trap door here.
I see it. I'll close it now.
Yeah,
okay. Oh, there I am.
All right.
Would you like to ride in my beautiful balloon? Would you like to glide in my beautiful balloon? We could float among the stars together, you and I. But we can't fly. Up, up and away, my beautiful balloon. The world's a nicer place in my beautiful balloon. It wears a nicer face in my beautiful balloon. We can sing a song and sail along a silver sky, but we can fly. Up, up and away, my beautiful balloon. Suspended under a twilight canopy, we'll search the clouds for a star to guide us. If by some chance you find yourself loving me, we'll find a cloud to guide us. Keep the moon beside us. Love's waiting there in my beautiful balloon. Way up in the air in my beautiful balloon. If you'll hold my hand, we'll chase your dream across the sky. But we can fly. Up, up and away. My beautiful balloon, look at it, my balloon, oh no, my balloon.
Well, then it's a deal, right? You clean up the dishes all this week, and I'll clean them up all next week, right?
All right.
Okay, good.
I'll clean them up all this week, and you'll clean them up all next week.
Right. See, then I won't be doing them all the time, you know? I will be taking turns. You do them 1 week, I'll do them another week. It's more fair that way, you know? It's more fun. Come on, Ernie, huh? Okay?
Hey, well, wait a minute, Bert.
What?
Wait a minute. How long is a week?
Well, you know, your regular week, see, on this calendar, you can see it. It's a Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. You see? That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 days, Ernie.
Ooh, 7 whole days of washing dishes?
Yeah.
At the end of 7 days of washing dishes, I'll be a wreck. That is a very long week.
Well, you know, every week is 7 days long, Ernie.
Well, I think I'm going to shorten this one.
You can't shorten a week.
Sure I can. I'll skip today.
How?
Well, like this. Hip, hip, hip.
Hey, hip, come on, Ernie. Hip, what are you doing? Hip.
I'm skipping today.
Spooky spiders.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
7 nickels.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
7 pumpkin pies. Oh.
You know, it's very important to know how to count. And James Earl Jones, well, he really knows how to count. Hey, I tell you what, why don't you try and count along with James Earl Jones right now, okay?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Hey, you're just in time to play a little game with Brendan, Lance, and I here. We have some animals inside this box, and we're going to see if Big Bird can guess what animal we have just by giving him some clues. And you can guess along too, okay? Are we ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, Big Bird.
Yeah, Bob.
Big Bird, come here a minute.
Sure.
Hey, would you like to play a game, Big Bird?
Oh, boy, I like games, Bob.
Do you? Okay, well, now here's the game. I have two little animals, same kind, in this box, and I'm going to see...
I know. An elephant and a hippopotamus.
No, that's impossible, no. Big Bird. They're okay. Both too big for this box. Now, I'm going to give you some clues and see if you can guess what kind of an animal. Mm-hmm. Now, first of all, each animal has 4 legs.
Four legs. You say?
1, 2, 3, 4
Whoa,
legs.
Oh, it must be a fish.
No.
Can't be a fish, Big Bird. Fish don't have legs.
Oh, okay.
Now, let me give you another clue. This animal cannot fly. It has...
Snake.
No,
snakes
cannot fly. No, it's not a snake. No,
okay.
It has hair all over it. And it's a nice pet.
A crocodile.
No.
Bryn, tell them what it is.
A guinea pig.
It's a guinea pig. You want to see them, Big Bird?
I knew that.
They're beautiful. Hey, Bryn, you hold one for me, will you?
Okay.
Oh. And here's another
cute.
One. These are our very own Sesame Street guinea pigs.
Hmm.
Aren't they nice, these? Yeah, right. These are Angora-type guinea pigs. Means they have long, soft hair. Some of them are sort of short-haired. But these have long hair, and they make really nice pets. They're a member of the same family as mice and rats. That's called a rodent family.
He looks a lot like a bunny rabbit without long ears.
Yes, he does. He does look like a bunny rabbit. They're cute little pets, and they're very clean, and they like to eat lettuce and all kinds of green things. You know, on the front of their feet, in their front feet, they have four toes on each foot, but on the back, they have six toes. Hey, let's count them together, okay? Bryn, do you want to count them for me while I hold them?
One, two, three, four, five, six.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Six. Six, six. Six.
Hey, Bob has asked me to go down check on his guinea pigs, and I will. And I'm going to ask you to come back and join us as soon as you can. Okay? You do that, too. Bye.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters J, O, and R, and by the numbers 6 and 7. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Public Television Network.